Welcome back to another episode of the Ark Switch Survival Guide. Today we are going to finally teach you all about Iguanadons in Ark. We'll show you how to tame an Iguanadon and why you want an Iguanadon on your team. Now, Iguanadons are really useful and they have a lot of unique abilities, like being able to jump almost two stories high. They can also sprint with infinite stamina when they run on all fours, and they are great at collecting berries from bushes around the Ark. They can also harvest thatch pretty effectively, and they have a unique ability that allows them to convert berries and vegetables instantly into seeds, which is great for farming. So they have a lot of really nice utility. Now, we probably should have tamed one a long time ago, but we're finally going to tame it today. You can get an Iguanadon saddle at level 30, so it's a reasonably low level, very good mount, and it's also very effective at carrying stuff. They make great pack animals. So today we're going to show you how to tame an Iguanadon, and we are going to use our frog for this entire tame. So if you have a frog in Ark, this video will also be very helpful to teach you all about taming dinos using the tranquilizing poison from the frog. So be sure to watch this whole episode, it will be really helpful. Now I'll start this video by showing you where to find an Iguanadon on the island map. And as you can see here, they're a somewhat rare spawn, but they can be found just about anywhere in the jungles and forests of Ark. Now, at about 8050 is where my main plateau base is, and I spotted a nice female Iguanadon at about 7550 coordinates, and that's where we're going to head over right now. This is Metal Mountain, which is a great place to find all kinds of helpful dinos. Now, it's a very low-level female, which is really kind of what I'm looking for right now. I won't be using her a whole lot, but I could use the eggs, and it's a great opportunity to go ahead and tame one for you guys. I haven't seen a ton of Iguanadons running around, and I usually just kind of tame good dinos when I see them across the mountain. So before I head out, I'm going to grab some meat for my frog to make sure it doesn't starve to death, and that'll give me a little bit of meat to force feed it if it gets low on health. Now, I have put a whole lot of health into this frog. It's a pretty high level frog, and it's got like 8,000 HP, so I'm really not worried about this Iguanadon hurting me. Now, it's a level 4 female, so it's not going to do too much damage any way you look at it, so I'm very comfortable using my frog to tame this dino. Now, you can tame an Iguanadon using tranquilizers, and it's actually really easy to tame because you can immobilize it with Ebola. But what I'm going to do is actually use my fancy taming pen that I've built, and I'm going to clear out a couple of trees that are just kind of in the way. So I have this massive taming pen, which I have been using lately, and you'll also notice I'm using this magnifying glass a little bit throughout this episode, and that's because I was actually doing this tame to demonstrate how you can use the magnifying glass in Ark, and I figured I'd do a full video on the tame. But as you can see, you can use a magnifying glass to identify what you're going to pick up from different resources like boulders, trees, bushes, and all that good stuff. Now, I'm trying to get up on top of these boulders, but I'm having a little trouble with my frog here. It just can't quite jump that high. So I'm gonna see if I can find a better way around here, even though I can almost make it up this ridge. I'm still kind of getting used to this frog's jumping trajectory, and I'm practicing a little bit with this frog. So I'm gonna head around this way, and we should be able to find the Iguanadon right up on top of this little ridge here, if I can make it up to it. So I think this might just about do it. Oh, I'm so close. Okay, we're just gonna go the long way around. This is just not working. Now, frogs are really helpful because you don't take very much fall damage from them, and you can jump down from a pretty high ledge like that without actually getting hurt, whereas most dinos would be hurt pretty badly. So we'll see if we can make it up here. Oh man, I just look like an idiot right now. So yeah, gotta practice a little bit more with my frog jumping, but that's okay. Now, I am being really careful. Oh, hey, dragonflies. Now, this is very helpful. Now, a frog can convert dragonflies directly into cementing paste. So, I just got 16 cementing paste and almost 30 chitin just from killing that dragonfly. They're a little bit hard to hit when they're up off the ground like this, so I'm going to try to jump and then use the tongue attack and see if I can hit this thing. They're definitely not easy to hit from there. There we go. Okay, well, I got a little bit more cementing paste, and that's going to help, and I don't think I'm going to be able to find that dragonfly in all those bushes, so we'll just stick with what I got here. And once again, demonstrating the magnifying glass, you can check out metal veins and all that good stuff. Now, here's a Dilophosaur, and I'm trying to kind of test the range of this magnifying glass, but it gets really glitchy because sometimes you end up checking out like piles of rocks or boulders or anything else that's kind of in the screen. It just can be a little bit difficult. And right here, I'm trying to check the torpidity and health of this Dilophosaur, and instead it's showing me the frog and the rock over here. So we're just gonna leave this guy alone. It's not really doing any good for me, so. And after you've attacked something with a frog, it actually applies a torpidity debuff to it and eventually knocks it unconscious, like this little guy here. So we've got a level 20 Dilophosaur. He's unconscious. I could probably tame him, but I just don't really want a Dilophosaur right now, so I'm just gonna leave him alone. We'll just agree to disagree on that one. So somewhere up here is the Iguanadon that I am interested in taming, and I think it's up on this slope that I saw it. I just periodically go on scouting expeditions over this mountain. There she is. Great. Now, Iguanadons are usually anywhere between, like, olive green and a nice orange color. They're a lot easier to spot when they're kind of this orange-tan color. But once again, I'm not getting a good health and torpidity read from this thing because it's just a little bit too far away. So we'll just see if we can attack her and get her to chase us a little bit, and we're going to try to bring her down to the river. Now, Iguanadons move reasonably quickly. They're a little bit hard to outrun, so make sure you know you're ready if you're going to pick a fight with an Iguanadon. They actually do pretty decent damage for an herbivore. It's not going to be enough to give me any trouble while I'm on my frog because it has like 8,000 health, and I can pretty quickly get away from it because my frog has pretty good movement speed. But I'm trying to stay just ahead of the Iguanadon, and they have decent swim speed, so I probably won't be able to lose it in the water too well. But he looks like he's just lost interest. They're very peaceful dinosaurs. They will not attack you unless you provoke them. So they're nice to keep around because they can actually do a pretty decent job fighting predators, and they've got decent health and weight too. There we go. So now you can see that I actually put about 43 torpidity damage to this guy. So he's about a quarter of the way towards passing out already. And she's got full health again, which means I can start fighting again and won't have to worry about killing her. Now, I can do pretty good damage with this frog, so I'm being really careful not to actually kill this Iguanadon because she is only level 4. It's going to make it really easy to knock her out, and once I've tamed her, I'll get a lot of free eggs, which are pretty helpful for kibbles. But right now, I just want to get her in here and try to make sure I keep her alive. So I'm not too worried about this thing killing me, so I felt pretty comfortable jumping off my frog to close the door. And let's see how we're doing here. Trying to check out her health and torpidity using this magnifying glass. There we go. So she's actually back to full health now that she started ignoring me again, but she's still got quite a lot of torpidity damage. So if I was super worried about her, I'd probably be shooting her with tranquilizers, but I'm not all that worried. So I'm doing a couple of attacks. I'm just using the right trigger to do his tongue attack twice, which puts 2 stacks of tranquilizing on her. And then if I hit the left trigger once, that puts a 3rd stack on. So I'm I'm trying to just keep all three stacks on this Iguanadon, and then I stop attacking, and there she goes. She is now passed out, and she's just about to die. So it's a good thing I had that magnifying glass to make sure I didn't put too much damage on her. So now she's unconscious. I'm just going to put a few berries into her inventory real quick, just so she's got something to snack on. And then I'm going to head back up to my base, because I've got a whole stack of lemons and carrots and vegetables, and vegetables are actually more effective than berries. So the least effective thing is regular berries like red, yellow, and blueberries. And the next least is mejo berries, which are decent for taming something. I could tame her without too much trouble since she's a low level just using mejo berries. But I'm going to grab a stack of lemons, which I've got in my refrigerator, and that will actually tame her up pretty darn quickly with decent taming effectiveness. So vegetables are always real good for herbivores. And as you can see, my Tapehara babies are getting a lot older. I think they're actually either juveniles or adolescents now. But I don't have to worry about feeding them anymore because they can eat out of the feeding trough. So I'm going to fly down on my Tapehara just to make this faster and easier. And I'll drop some lemons in its inventory. And I'm probably not even going to really need to use any narcotics or biotoxin to keep this thing unconscious. I'll just feed it these little narco berries that I just picked up. And that should be enough to keep her unconscious until she tames up, because she's taming pretty fast. She's only a level 4, so that's pretty easy to tame. So we're going to keep taming up that Iguanadon. It should not take too long, because once again, they're pretty easy to tame compared to a lot of dinos, and this is a very low level one as it is. So we're going to do a few things around the base, and we'll be right back while that Iguanadon finishes taming up. And we're back. She is just about tamed up. Now she's tamed up. So I finally finished taming this Iguanadon. And I used to have a pair of iguanodons named Tijuana and Tijuanita, I don't know. So we'll just name her that for now. If you guys have a better name in mind, please feel free to drop a suggestion in the comments. I always love hearing your suggestions on what to name dinosaurs. And one of these days we'll have a whole episode where I'm just gonna name all the dinosaurs. So there's that tree that's just floating in the air, and that's kind of been bothering me, so I'm just gonna destroy that, because, I mean, come on, it's breaking the laws of gravity here. You can't break the law, you gotta go. So I'm gonna head back up to my base, and I'm gonna come down with my Argent Avis, because that is the fastest way to get this Iguanadon back up to my plateau. Now I could just have her follow me all the way around, but there's nothing faster and safer than just having an Argent pick up your dino. Now I forgot she was on follow, so I'll whistle for her to stop and set her to passive. That's always the first most important thing I need to do with all of my new tames, is set them on passive, so if a dinosaur does attack my plateau, which I haven't seen anything dangerous for a very long time up here, but if a dino does come up here, I don't want my dinosaurs attacking it, because they might actually jump off the plateau where it's not safe. So this is a huge area. I've got a bunch of foundations that are placed all along the ground, and that prevents any dinos from spawning up here inside my base perimeter. So I'm going to go ahead and learn the saddle for the Iguanadon, and for some reason you can type in the search bar I-G-U-A-N, but not iguana, and it will actually show up. That's kind of weird, but whatever. Now, I've got one of my baby Tapeharas, and his head is in the way of the door, so I can barely get into my base. These guys are getting pretty big, so I'm going to have to move them outside pretty soon. So the Iguanadon saddle is something you can learn at level 30. It's a pretty easy saddle to make. We just need some fiber, hide, and wood, not even a crazy huge amount of those. So you can get this about 8 levels before you can get your first flyer, which is the Pteranodon saddle at level 38. And this is a really great way to get around the island, because Iguanadons basically have infinite stamina. So I'm going to drop off the rest of these lemons, and I can't believe I have 50 Tapehara eggs. That's crazy. That should be enough to make all the kibble I'm going to need to tame a lot of the dinos that I want. That's why I have so many Tapeharas, and I'm getting more. That just kind of gives me an infinite kibble factory. So now I'm going to equip the saddle on this Iguanadon, and I'll show you some of the cool things that an Iguanadon can do. Now, one of my favorite things about an Iguanadon is if you hit the left trigger, it will switch between running on all fours and standing on its hind legs, kind of like a Spinosaurus can do. But it gets a lot more maneuverable on two legs, and the really cool thing is it can jump almost two stories high. So if your base is two stories high, you can actually park your Iguanadons on the roof and just jump them up there, and that'll keep them safe from most predators that are smaller than a Tyrannosaur. They can just live on top of your roof, and it's a really great spot to keep them safe. So we're gonna head down into the jungle, and I'll show you some of the other cool abilities of an Iguanadon in just a second. And we're back, and you can see that I am sprinting on all fours. After I hit the left trigger to switch to all fours, I am not using any stamina, even though I'm sprinting full speed and moving pretty darn fast. So you can cross the entire island with an Iguanadon without ever running out of stamina, sprinting the entire time. Now, if you use the right trigger, it's going to do its attack on bushes, and it will actually gather tons of berries. It's more efficient than a Triceratops. Not quite as much as a Stegosaur, I think, but it's still very good at gathering berries. Now, I'm going to hop up on these rocks, and I'll show you another cool ability that the Iguanadon has. Not a lot of people use this, but if you need to get some seeds for farming, you can click this ability. If you hold down X, you get to the menu, and it has the seed fruit in inventory. And if I were to hit that, it will convert every single berry into the seeds of that berry. So if I kept my narco berries in its inventory, for example, I would now have 51 narco berry seeds, which can then be planted in a crop plot and used for gardening. And I will probably put a link in the description for how to do gardening in Ark, because an Iguanadon is a very helpful thing if you want to do gardening. So I'll grab a few more berries here, and another thing you can do is if you attack a tree, it actually gathers a whole lot of thatch. I think it's more efficient at gathering thatch than a Triceratops, but it's pretty nice for that too. And it has pretty decent weight, so Iguanodons make more efficient pack animals than even like a Parasaur or anything like that. So they're very helpful, and they're extremely fast. They can cross the entire island without getting tired. So if you've got to carry some stuff all the way across the island, an Iguanodon is a very good way to do that. Now, I'm going to demonstrate one more helpful thing. Let's say you got yourself a couple of carrots, and you don't have any carrot seeds. If you want to plant some carrots, you can just take those vegetables to your Iguanadon, put them in its inventory, and then I'm going to tell it to seed those carrots. And now I have, let me actually get some of these berries out that I want to keep as berries, like the narco berries and stem berries. I might be using those later. So now I'm going to tell him to seed everything in his inventory. And as you can see, we now have three carrot seeds instead of the carrots. And vegetables are much more rare to get their seeds, so that can be very helpful if you're wanting to make a whole bunch of garden plots. So that's most of the reasons that I love Iguanodons in Ark. They are a great lower level mount, and they've got a lot of utility. So I'd love to hear from you guys if you use Iguanodons in your own Ark adventures. Drop a comment and let me know if you have one and why you like them. Also, if you have any other tips that I have not covered about using Iguanodons in Ark, I would love to hear about it. And please like this video if it helped you at all, and subscribe to this channel, and be sure to enable notifications, ring that bell when you subscribe, and it will tell you when the next video comes out, which should be in a couple of days. Also, my wife and I have a new YouTube channel that we are working on together, which is called the Console Co-op Couple. We do a lot of console games, and we would love it if you would check out the link in the description, go over there, and subscribe to that channel as well. That would actually help us out a lot. So until next time, I hope you have safe and fun adventures on Ark, and we'll see you in the next video.
Thanks so much for watching this video from the Ark Survival Guide. If you enjoyed it or found it helpful, please like this video and subscribe to our channel so we can bring you more great guides like this one. Ark is an amazing game, but there is so much to learn before you can really enjoy it. We are dedicated to bringing you high-quality guides, tutorials, and Let's Play videos that are fun, helpful, clean, and suitable for the entire family. There's a tutorial in this series for everything we have done so far in this video. Check out these playlists for more episodes from this series and other guides to help you enjoy your journey on Ark.